guys, I'm Maylin Dovan, certified athletic therapist and founder of Rehab U Movement and Performance Therapy. Welcome to our YouTube channel. The topic of this week's video is elbow rehab. I have the honor of being with Sabrina, who is a national level boxer. So she's been a national for the past 7 years, turning pro this year, and we're working together to get her through an elbow injury. A lot of our work together is holding her back, among other things, because she said she can't wait to punch someone in the face, she said to me. So I want to talk to you specifically about hypermobility in this case. So Sabrina's been struggling with an elbow injury, and there are several elements to that that we're looking at, namely a little bit of neural stuff, but I want to talk about her hypermobility specifically in this capsule. Hey guys, thanks for watching our videos, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Now she's someone who has pretty general laxity, she's pretty mobile. We did notice, however, that on the left side versus the right side, she's got more elbow hyperextension, a little bit more medial instability on a valgus stress test. So those are some elements that we're working on in her rehab, because obviously, as she releases a punch, she needs to be able to control that hyperextension and hypermobility. So a part of her activation sequence is building awareness to prevent hyperextension. Now, obviously, a lot of the bulk of her work is, you know, working on grip strength, working on the muscles of the forearm. We're gonna need muscles, and she's got a little bit of disused atrophy from protecting that elbow. She's been struggling with pain for quite a few months. But aside from doing the strengthening of the forearms, we need to bring awareness to that hyperextension. It's become very sensitive. So we need to kind of convince the nervous system that it's okay to load that limb. We need to work on controlling that hyperextension. And then we also need to have an element of reactive stability, right? Because there's having the proprioception to control the extension, but there's the element of having to decelerate forces. So we're going to take you through a few exercises that are in her phase one rehab plan. So one of the first elements in her activation sequence is a limb load tolerance exercise, okay, from our from the guys over at IKN. Okay, so we're trying to improve that upper extremity's capacity to tolerate load. So you'll see here, we're gonna get her hand just a little bit off the box, good. And we want her to keep slight bend in the elbow and then round up the upper back. And she's leaning into that, but at the same time, she's pushing into the box. So we're creating load through the entire upper extremity. She's just pushing in the box slightly, just enough to hold herself in that position and breathing in that position. Now, I have her doing this. You can come on out of there, Sabrina. I have her doing this for 5 times 10 seconds rather than an extended time, just because there was a lot of apprehension going into that position initially. So another exercise that's in her activation sequence, we're replicating kind of the same thing, but in an open chain context. So now she's got a weight that she's holding. She's got to keep the wrist neutral. She's got to keep the alignment, wrist, elbow, and shoulder, and be aware of not hyperextending, but also not flexing the wrist or elbow. Okay, so just working on stabilizing that kind of end range and controlling that end range. Now, in order to work on reactive stability, we want Sabrina to work on having to extend and flex quickly, right? So to work on that reaction. So this is one of the drills that I have her do. It's a catch and release, where initially she'll start with the same arm. So we're dealing with left elbow. So she releases the ball and then catches it as quickly as possible. Obviously, the faster she is, the less extension she's gonna have to use to grab the ball. If I have her drop the ball with the opposite hand and catch with the left, then she's gonna have to get a little bit more extension. That happens with this drill. So you see the picture, when she has to drop the ball with the opposite hand, she's gonna have to get more extension or use more extension to go and catch that ball and bring it back. So we're just starting to work on that quick acceleration, deceleration, or accelerating to catch the ball and then bringing the ball back. Okay, so starting to work on controlling that hyperextension in a more dynamic environment. All right, so These are just some of the elements in Sabrina's first phase of rehab. There's more details in the article that's attached to this video on our blog. You know, we've also got obviously some forearm strengthening, the classic stuff, some tendon glide exercises, those kind of things that are really interesting for rehabbing the medial or lateral elbow as well. Okay, so remember, you want to work on creating awareness to control hypermobility, because with hypermobility comes a little bit of proprioceptive deficit, but then you also need to have the reactive stability. You need to slowly bring that into a more dynamic environment so you can have the transfer to sport. So you need conscious awareness, and then you have to bring that conscious awareness to a point where it becomes unconscious. All right, so see you next week.